Chris Hogan here. I've spent so much time on the road and talked with a lot of people. And the millionaire success stories that I run into might surprise you. Whether I'm at an event or talking on my podcast, one thing has become clear. Most people have no idea what a self-made millionaire really looks like. You're going to get a glimpse into the life of a self-made millionaire. These folks are hard at work. You don't want to miss it, people. This is Millionaire.
We're going to start off with Larry in Medford, Oregon. Hey, Larry, how are you?
Hey, I'm doing great. Better than I imagined.
I love it. So what's your net worth, sir?
Well, we're actually closing in on $4 million today.
Right at $4 million. Good for you.
My name is Larry from Southern Oregon, and my wife, Dee. I'm a graphic design advertising executive. After about a 30-year career, it was time to, you know, kind of scale back a little bit.
And I've always been in the printing industry, so I started out working for my father, later went into sales. So I've been in sales for about 30 years, and I'm still working.
I started at San Diego State and then transferred to Art Center College of Design and got my Bachelor of Fine Arts there. Started in Del Mar as an art director. My starting salary at that time was $21,000 a year, which was about $11 an hour. And you were probably in that same
$18,000.
And then I just slowly built, and it worked up to, you know, $100,000 in the end. And there were some spikes in there. You had some big job years where, you know, a lot of things happened to come through in that 1 year. And we started making enough money that we could actually afford some nicer things in life. But we were still playing that game of, you know, credit cards and having a lot of debt building up and getting a car loan and that sort of thing, like everyone else does.
I agree that we were not particularly focused on any goal when we first started out. It was basically, you know, probably like everyone else, we weren't making huge sums of money and we were living paycheck to paycheck.
But as time went by, we started realizing that, hey, we're working really hard, but yet the money's just kind of staying flat. And my parents had taught me early on, they were successful in their careers and started getting involved in real estate, that there's something greater that we want to become. And, you know, how this, we can't just be in the squirrel wheel forever. So we started thinking about plans and making some adjustments.
Well, probably my first awareness of trying to save for retirement came through company offering 401k. I researched that, realized that it seemed like a good way to start investing. So I, you know, did what I could every year to fill that up. And then, you know, he ended up with something similar.
Yeah, buying the advertising business that had been around for 35 years and was very successful. I took on that task of being the president and creative director. I started a 401k for everyone that worked for me. And so that kind of started to get my interest. Doing the research on how to set this up for a company now starts to, you know, bring that home to me, like, oh, well, this is a real thing. We had a little bit of extra money and just started putting that away. But I kind of compare it to the tortoise and the hare, that we weren't like so rabid about, oh, we need all this money and we need, just need to work, and, you know, work 18 hours a day and this sort of thing. I think if you're after a quick fix and a quick success, I think leads to more disappointment, because that's such a very chancy thing that that'll even happen. And I think if you can get in the mentality of building slowly, quickly, you'll look behind and you'll see you actually are progressing. And so just give it time. I mean, time is in your favor when you're young. You know, if you follow the math and, you know, 10% interest will double your investment every 10 years, it just kind of happens. You know, if you don't, you know, fall on your face too many times and you keep picking yourself up and learning from any mistakes that you make, that over the time, 30, 40 years, you'll be quite successful if you just stay the path and be true to yourself, and it will come.
Well, one of the benefits of waiting and saving and getting to the point where you're actually able to change your life. For us, we wanted to break out of our routine that we had, do something different, and we were able to relocate to this home, which we've really fallen in love with. And we have the Rogue River right outside our window and a gigantic 200-year-old redwood tree also that we enjoy. You know, it was a really wonderful opportunity for us to do something pretty amazing.
I'm a big opportunist when it comes to, you know, doors opening where you aren't afraid to walk through that threshold.
The interesting aspect of our lives is that we've always been curious about doing a lot of different things. So I see that as just a really fun goal for the future, too. It's like, what else is coming up that we can do and be interested in?
Yeah, I would say the key to success is tenacity and just going for what can better yourself and in turn better other people. You know, I grew up wanting to be an artist. I mean, it's a possibility for everyone. We lived in a kind of remote area of San Diego County and surrounded by trees and brush. Well, there's a huge fire that came to town from a short in an electric line and really high winds coming from the east. And we basically had to escape our house in the middle of flames and really barely made it out. Houses were burning.
We couldn't see where we were going.
And then I get to that leading edge of the orange flames. We can't stop. So I actually had to drive into the fire. And the police were signaling us through. I think we probably surprised them. How are cars coming out of there? And we all hugged each other and thought, wow. And you know, living through that experience, you know, you're never satisfied with where you are. You're always pushing and you always want to do something better. And just like escaping the fire and the success of living and to have another day, you don't just stop and wait and burn. Keep moving forward, I think, would be a key in finding success.